हेलो फ्रेंड्स, इन स्टैंडर्ड 10 मैथ्स टुडे वी टेक अ न्यू चैप्टर, चैप्टर नंबर 7, कोऑर्डिनेट ज्योमेट्री। इट इज माय फर्स्ट लेक्चर इन दिस चैप्टर। फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल लेट अस अंडरस्टैंड द मीनिंग ऑफ कोऑर्डिनेट ज्योमेट्री। ज्योमेट्री वी नो इट फ्रॉम अर्ली स्टैंडर्ड्स। जियो मीन्स अर्थ और एनी ऑब्जेक्ट ऑन द अर्थ, एंड मेट्री मीन्स अ प्रोसेस ऑफ मेजरिंग। सो एनी स्ट्रक्चर वी मेजर वी कॉल इट ज्योमेट्री। कोऑर्डिनेट, फॉर दिस आई शुड टेक यू टू अ ब्रीफ जर्नी ऑफ स्टैंडर्ड 9। वी हैड वन चैप्टर विद द सेम नेम इन स्टैंडर्ड 9 ऑल्सो, कोऑर्डिनेट ज्योमेट्री। इन दैट वी हैव स्टडीड कार्टेशियन कोऑर्डिनेट सिस्टम। ओके, सो वी जस्ट आई स्टार्ट विद द एग्जाम्पल। Suppose you purchase a ticket for a movie, and on the ticket you must have read something like this, P17. Okay, it is your number to sit in the theater. So what is P and what is 17? Suppose you are given instead these two only P, that you go and sit in the row P. So in the row P, which seat you will select? A problem. Other way, suppose they give only a number that you go to seat number 17 in the theater. Then there are many, many rows. Each row has the chair having number 17. So which row you will sit in? That is why just to locate your seat properly, P17 means you have to find out row P, and in that row P you have to find out number 17, that is your place to sit. Okay, so ultimately two things are required to locate one object in the system that we have studied from Cartesian coordinate system. Ultimately Cartesian coordinate system is a set of ordered pairs. Suppose I write an ordered pair x comma y, then the first number it is to be watched on x axis, that is x coordinate axis, and y it is to be watched from y coordinate axis. So what are coordinate axes? That also we study. Of course we have studied it already. Suppose in the plane we choose two lines which are mutually perpendicular, then they are the two coordinate axes. The horizontal we call it x-axis, and the vertical we call it y-axis. In that, the point at which they intersect each other at a right angle, it is called origin, it is zero. Okay, on the right side of the origin on x-axis there are positive numbers, as you know, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 onwards. On the left hand side it contains negative number. If I take only x-axis, you can check it works as a number line. In the same way, suppose one number line I take vertical, not horizontal, and I call it y-axis, then from the origin, the upper part of y-axis, it takes the positive numbers, as you know already, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 onwards. And on the lower side, on the y-axis, that is containing negative numbers, minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4, minus 5, and so on. So these, we use two axes to draw the graph. You have drawn certain graphs in standard 9 also. So this you know. Okay, now it is x-axis. The horizontal line in the Cartesian coordinate plane is called x-axis, and the line which is vertical to x-axis in the same plane is called y-axis. For understanding the positive end I say x, and negative end I got with x dash. In the same way here y, it is y dash. It is traditional to write, okay, not compulsory. Okay, now what is the position of the point here on their graph paper? One thing, suppose I write that x and y, it is an ordered pair, I want to locate in the graph paper. So what do you mean by x? X is a number, you have to check how much far it is from y-axis. A point, how much away from y-axis, on right hand side or left hand side, it is your x. So distance of a point from y-axis is its x coordinate, and we call it abscissa. X coordinate, we call it abscissa. In the same way, a point, how much away from x-axis, either on the lower side or on the upper side, it is known as ordinate or y coordinate. These you have studied in standard 9. Okay, so ultimately, if I want to know the position of a point, then I should check how much it is away from y-axis, that is its x-coordinate, and how much it is away from x-axis, it is called its ordinate or y-coordinate. Okay, now suppose some point is lying, suppose it is a point, it is a point A, it is on x-axis and it is showing the point 3. So what can be the ordered pair for point A? As I told you, this point, it is how much away from y-axis is called A. So from y-axis it is 1, 2 and 3 units away, so its abscissa is 3. Now this point, it is how much away from x-axis, it is already on the x-axis, so distance of the point from x-axis is 0, so its ordinate, that is y-coordinate, is 0. So a number lying on x-axis has always ordinate or y-coordinate 0. In the same way, suppose some number, it is lying here, it is point B. It is showing minus 3 on y-axis, okay? Now let's check, how much away point B is from y-axis? It is already on the y-axis, so its abscissa is 0. Now how much this point is away from x-axis? 1, 2 and 3, but it is minus 3, negative side, so its ordinate is minus 3. So this is how we locate the point, and by drawing the coordinate axis, the plane or the graph paper is divided into 4 parts. Each part is known as a quadrant. Okay, it is quadrant 1, it is quadrant 2, it is quadrant 3, and it is quadrant 4. So you have to move anti-clockwise. Okay, so any pair, any ordered pair lying in the first quadrant, what is the type of the ordered pair there? Positive, positive. So positive, positive, it is the type of the ordered pair lying in the first quadrant. What about the ordered pair lying in the second quadrant? X negative, y is positive. So it is negative, comma, positive. Third quadrant, x negative, y also negative. So it is negative, comma, negative. And the last one, fourth one, x is positive, y is negative, so it is positive, negative. So these all we have learned in standard 9, okay? So knowing this, we try to, or we just do a exercise only, or you can say an activity by which we plot the given points in the graph paper, okay? So here I take you to a graph paper. We have to plot certain points, and we plot the points and let us know what figure is generated. I take the activity from the textbook only, on the very first page of the page. Point A, 4, 8, it is origin. Point A, 4 and 8. So it is the point A, 4, 8, okay? B, 3, 9, 3 and 9. It is here. It is point B. Now C, 3, 8. 3, 8. It is C. D, 1, 6. 1, 6. It is D. 1, 5. It is E. 3, 3. It is F. 6, 3. It is G. 8, 5. It is H. Then 8, 6. It is I. Then after I it is J. 6, 8. 6, 8. It is J. 6, 9. 6 and 9. It is K. Okay. And L. 5, 8. 5, 8 is L. So I have to connect them, A to B to C to D to E to F, that way, in order I want to connect. So first of all, A to B, B to C, C to D, D to E, E to F, F to G, G to H, H to I to J, J to K, K to L, and L to again A. So can you assume what kind of figure is developed here? According to me, it is the line out diagram of our artificial satellite Aryabhatta, if you remember it. It is my view, your view can be changed, I am not sure, but according to me, it looks like the outline of Aryabhatta artificial satellite of India. Okay. More points are given. X 5.5, 7. 5.5 is somewhere here and 7 is here. So this is X. Then 5, 6. 5 and 6. It is Y. And 6, 6. 6, 6. It is Z. So I can form a triangle here. I tell you afterwards what does it mean. Okay. Next point, 4, 5 is S. 4, 5. It is S. 4.5 with 4. 4.5 is here and 4 is here. It is T. And 5, 5 is U. It is U. Again form a triangle. Okay. And finally, join S to 0, 5. 0, 5 is here. S with 0, 5 and S with 0, 6. So now it is very much clear that the two windows or the wings of Aryabhatta along with its wings, that if you see the picture of Aryabhatta, I think you can find it is similar to Aryabhatta. But by doing this exercise, we just learned or we just remember, we recollected the memory that how to plot the points in the graph paper. Okay, nothing more. So it is over. Now I take you to one more graph. Suppose it is said that a village A is a village and one village B, it is lying at 36 kilometers north and 15 kilometers east from A. So it is a town named B. So now the location of town B, you are given two dimensions. So they are one from x axis, second from y axis. So it is an ordered pair, 36, 15. Okay. So from A, first of all, go to east direction. How much it is? 36 kilometers. I'm sorry, it is east, it is north. So 36 to east. So it is some point C. Now from there again, 15 kilometers north. So go 15 here. It is your point B and this distance is 15. Now, can you find out the distance AB? Tell me. So, you can very easily judge that you are getting a right angle triangle. And in the right angle triangle, you are given two sides which form the right angle. And how to find the remaining side, that is hypotenuse, you know. How to find it? Just recollect your memory. Yes, it is Pythagoras principle. So what is Pythagoras principle? In the right angle triangle, the square of the hypotenuse is equal to sum of the squares of the two sides which make the right angle. So you are very much familiar with this statement, and by doing this way, 36 square plus 15 square, whatever is the answer, you take the square root of it and get the value of AB. Okay? So the time comes, we'll do the same question and find the answer. Okay? And we take one more. The figure is ready here. Two points are given, A 40, B 60. They are on x axis. Two points on y axis, C 03 and D 08. So I want to find out CA and I want to find out BD. So again, you can check, it is right angle triangle. So CA square is equal to, it is suppose O, so OC square plus OA square. OC is how much? 3. 3 square is 9. It is 4. 4 square is 16. 16 plus 9, 25. So CA square is 25, so CA is equal to 5. In the same way, you go for this and find out BD. How much it is? 8. So 8 square is 64 plus, how much it is? 6. 6 square is 36. Total is 100 and square root of 100 is equal to 10. So hypotenuse is 10. So this is how we are going to find out the value of the hypotenuse using Pythagoras. So now for this period it is okay. And now in the next period, we'll take some more examples of the text and then we'll go for the exercise of the chapter. So for now, thank you very much. Hello friends, in standard 10 maths, today we take a new chapter, chapter number 7, coordinate geometry. It is my first lecture in this chapter. First of all, let us understand the meaning of coordinate geometry. Geometry, we know it from early standards. Geo means earth or any object on the earth, and metry means a process of measuring. So any structure we measure, we call it geometry. Coordinate. For this, I should take you to a brief journey of standard 9. We had one chapter with the same name in standard 9 also, coordinate geometry. In that, we have studied Cartesian coordinate system. Okay? So we just, I start with the example. Suppose you purchase a ticket for a movie, and on the ticket you must have read something like this, P17. Okay? It is your number to sit in the theater. So what is P and what is 17? Suppose you are given instead these two only P, that you go and sit in the row P. So in the row P, which seat you will select? A problem. Other way, suppose they give only a number that you go to seat number 17 in the theater. Then there are many, many rows. Each row has the chair having number 17. So which row you will sit in? That is why just to locate your seat properly, P17 means you have to find out row P, and in that row P you have to find out number 17, that is your place to sit. Okay? So ultimately two things are required to locate one object in the system that we have studied from Cartesian coordinate system. Ultimately, Cartesian coordinate system is a set of ordered pairs. Suppose I write an ordered pair x, y, then the first number, it is to be washed on x-axis, that is x-coordinate axis, and y, it is to be washed from y-coordinate axis. So what are coordinate axes? That also we study. Of course, we have studied it already. Suppose in the plane, we choose two lines which are mutually perpendicular, then they are the two coordinate axes. The horizontal, we call it x-axis, and the vertical, we call it y-axis. In that, the point at which they intersect each other at a right angle, it is called origin, it is zero. Okay? On the right side of the origin on x-axis, there are positive numbers. As you know, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 onwards. On the left hand side, it contains negative number. If I take only x-axis, you can check it works as a number line. In the same way, suppose one number line I take vertical, not horizontal, and I call it y-axis. Then from the origin, the upper part of y-axis, it takes the positive numbers, as you know already, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 onwards, and on the lower side on the y-axis, that is containing negative numbers, minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4, minus 5, and so on. So these, we use two axes to draw the graph. You have drawn certain graphs in standard 9 also. So this you know, okay? Now, it is x-axis, the horizontal line in the Cartesian coordinate plane is called x-axis, and the line which is vertical to x-axis in the same plane is called y-axis. For understanding the positive end, I say x, and negative end, I got with x-dash. In the same way here, y, it is y-dash. It is traditional to write, okay? Not compulsory. Okay, now what is the position of the point here on the graph paper? One thing, suppose I write that x and y, it is an ordered pair, I want to locate in the graph paper. So what do you mean by x? X is a number, you have to check how much far it is from y-axis. A point, how much away from y-axis on right-hand side or left-hand side, it is your x. So distance of a point from y-axis is its x-coordinate, and we call it abscissa. X-coordinate, we call it abscissa. In the same way, a point, how much away from x-axis, either on the lower side or on the upper side, it is known as ordinate or y-coordinate. These you have studied in standard 9, okay? So ultimately, if I want to know the position of a point, then I should check how much it is away from y-axis, that is its x-coordinate, and how much it is away from x-axis, it is called its ordinate or y-coordinate, okay? Now, suppose some point is lying, suppose it is a point. It is a point A. It is on x-axis and it is showing the point 3. So, what can be the ordered pair for point A? As I told you, this point, it is how much away from y-axis is called A. So, from y-axis, it is 1, 2 and 3 units away. So, its abscissa is 3. Now, this point, it is how much away from x-axis, it is already on the x-axis, so distance of the point from x-axis is 0, so its ordinate, that is y-coordinate, is 0. So a number lying on x-axis has always ordinate or y-coordinate 0. In the same way, suppose some number, it is lying here, it is point B. It is showing minus 3 on y-axis, okay? Now let's check. How much away point B is from y-axis? It is already on the y-axis, so its abscissa is 0. Now how much this point is away from x-axis? 1, 2 and 3, but it is minus 3, negative side. So its ordinate is minus 3. So this is how we locate the point, and by drawing the coordinate axis, the plane or the graph paper is divided into 4 parts. Each part is known as a quadrant. Okay, it is quadrant 1, it is quadrant 2, it is quadrant 3, and it is quadrant 4. So you have to move anti-clockwise, okay? So any pair, any ordered pair lying in the first quadrant, what is the type of the ordered pair there? Positive, positive. So positive, positive. It is the type of the ordered pair lying in the first quadrant. What about the ordered pair lying in the second quadrant? X negative, Y is positive. So it is negative, comma, positive. Third quadrant, X negative, Y also negative. So it is negative, comma, negative. And the last one, fourth one, X is positive, Y is negative. So it is positive, negative. So these all we have learned in standard 9, okay? So knowing this, we try to, or we just do a exercise only, or you can say an activity by which we plot the given points in the graph paper, okay? So here I take you to a graph paper. We have to plot certain points, and we plot the points and let us know what figure is generated. I take the activity from the textbook only, on the very first page of the page. Point A, 4, 8. It is origin. Point A, 4 and 8. So it is the point A, 4, 8. Okay. B, 3, 9. 3 and 9. It is here. It is point B. Now C, 3, 8. 3, 8. It is C. D, 1, 6. 1, comma 6. It is D. 1, 5. 1, 5. It is E. 3, 3. 3, 3. It is F. 6, 3. 6, 3. It is G. 8, 5. 8 and 5. It is H. Then 8, 6. 8, 6. It is I. Then after I, it is J, 6, 8. 6, 8. It is J. 6, 9. 6 and 9. It is K. Okay? And L, 5, 8. 5, 8 is L. So I have to connect them, A to B to C to D to E to F, that way, in order I want to connect. So first of all, A to B, B to C, C to D, D to E, E to F, F to G, G to H, H to I to J, J to K, K to L, and L to again A. So can you assume what kind of figure is developed here? According to me, it is the line out diagram of our artificial satellite Aryabhatta, if you remember it. It is my view, your view can be changed, I am not sure, but according to me, it looks like the outline of Aryabhatta artificial satellite of India. Okay. More points are given. X, 5.5, 7. 5.5 is somewhere here, and 7 is here. So this is X. Then 5, 6. 5 and 6. It is y. And 6, 6. 6, 6. It is z. So I can form a triangle here. I tell you afterwards what does it mean. Okay. Next point, 4, 5 is s. 4, 5. It is s. 4.5 with 4. 4.5 is here and 4 is here. It is t. And 5, 5 is u. It is u. Again form a triangle. Okay. And finally, join s to 0, 5. 0, 5 is here. S with 0, 5 and S with 0, 6. So now it is very much clear that the two windows or the wings of Aryabhata, along with its wings, that if you see the picture of Aryabhata, I think you can find it is similar to Aryabhata. But by doing this exercise, we just learned or we just remember, we recollected the memory that how to plot the points in the graph paper. Okay, nothing more. So it is over. Now I take you to one more graph. Suppose it is said that a village A is a village and one village B, it is lying at 36 kilometers north and 15 kilometers east from A. So it is a town named B. So now the location of town B, you are given two dimensions. So they are one from x axis, second from y axis. So it is an ordered pair, 36, 15. Okay. So from A, first of all, go to east direction. How much it is? 36 kilometers. I'm sorry, it is east, it is north. So 36 to east, so it is some point C. Now from that again, 15 kilometer north. So go 15 here, it is your point B, and this distance is 15. Now can you find out the distance AB? Tell me. So you can very easily judge that you are getting a right angle triangle. And in the right angle triangle, you are given two sides which form the right angle. And how to find the remaining side, that is hypotenuse, you know. How to find it? Just recollect your memory. Yes, it is Pythagoras principle. So what is Pythagoras principle? In the right angle triangle, the square of the hypotenuse is equal to sum of the squares of the two sides which make the right angle. So you are very much familiar with this statement, and by doing this way, 36 square plus 15 square, whatever is the answer, you take the square root of it and get the value of AB. Okay? So the time comes, we'll do the same question and find the answer. Okay? And we take one more. The figure is ready here. Two points are given. A 40, B 60, they are on x axis. Two points on y axis, C 03 and D 08. So I want to find out CA and I want to find out BD. So again you can check, it is right angle triangle. So CA square, CA square is equal to, it is suppose O, so OC square plus OA square. OC is how much? 3. 3 square is 9. It is 4. 4 square is 16. 16 plus 9, 25. So CA square is 25, so CA is equal to 5. In the same way, you go for this and find out BD. How much it is? 8. So 8 square is 64 plus how much it is? 6. 6 square is 36. Total is 100 and square root of 100 is equal to 10. So hypotenuse is 10. So this is how we are going to find out the value of the hypotenuse using Pythagoras. So now for this period it is okay, and now in the next period we will take some more examples of the text and then we will go for the exercise of the chapter. So for now, thank you very much.